So in this video presentation, we're going to look at the three-phase safe isolation procedure, a procedure needed for AM2 and AM2S, as well as working as a contracting electrician. We're going to safely isolate this distribution board behind me. We're going to secure the isolation and we're going to prove it's dead with a proving unit and a voltage indicator. However, in the classroom, before starting this exercise, we have discussed things like permits to work, signs and barriers, and other procedures that need to be considered before the safe isolation process begins. This video is at the point where we're now going to carry out the safe isolation. We want to carry out the safe isolation in the safest possible manner. So it means we won't be going in and just throwing the main switch here. And in this case, we also have a remote switch. So this switch here will also isolate this distribution board. We have other switches around the workshop that also can be used for isolating the distribution board. So we're going to work in the safest possible manner. Exactly the same as we did with a single phase consumer unit. We're going to isolate individual circuits first. So we end up turning off the main switches with no current being drawn, or hopefully no current being drawn. So what we don't want to do is start throwing this switch with all the circuits currently energized. So let's go about that next. So we're going to turn off individual circuit breakers, reducing the current down that the main switch will obviously isolate, expecting it to be zero. So we've turned off all of the devices within the distribution board. We next throw the main switch, which can be tricky. Okay, and we've thrown that offload, so there's no current going through it. And as we have a remote switch away from the consumer unit, or distribution board in this case, we can turn that one off as well. That's the one we're going to secure the isolation process on. Often on AM2 and AM2S rigs, there is a remote switch to isolate the distribution board you're working on. And this is the position where we will lock it off and put our sign before entering the distribution board in order to prove the circuit is dead. So let's lock off our isolator here before entering this electrical enclosure. Remember, we should have been looking for signs of things going off. So as I was turning off individual circuit breakers, we should have been noticing maybe lights, sockets, machines, etc. going off. So when we do enter the electrical enclosure, we are considering it to be isolated, but working in a manner that suggests that if it was live, that we're still working safely, especially when we're thinking about metallic enclosures being removed. So care still needs to be taken when removing the covers, but we're in a position where we think it's been isolated safely, but we're going through that process to prove it in the next few stages. So as we have a remote means of isolation for our distribution board, this is the point in which we're going to secure the isolation. I believe something very similar on AM2 and AM2S. Padlock, key and sign. I'm not going to use the master lock this time. So I'm just going to position that through there like so. Take my sign, position it like so, and lock it off. Super duper important that you keep the key. Do not place it on the top. Put it into your pocket. If you leave it behind where the assessor can get hold of it, you will fail either AM2 or AM2S. So keep the key. So I'm now in a position where I can remove the front of this distribution board. I believe I've isolated it correctly, but I'm still going in with care and caution. Okay, I'm going to remove the four screws. In this case, I can take the door off this style, so I'm going to take the door off to make it easier. I'm going to remove the front four screws, and then I'm in there, and I'll be looking at then proving unit, voltage indicator, and the process in order to confirm the bottom of this main switch has been isolated. Taking it off to remove it, and we're now looking at where we're going to actually prove that this distribution board has been isolated in the next part of the video. So at the minute we've got the guards in place, so I cannot see the incoming supply cable's termination point, so I'm going to have to access this area here, and it says danger voltage. We're hoping that we've isolated it remotely. We know the main switch off, but care needs to be taken when entering this enclosure. So when we're going in here, again, be very careful, insulated screwdrivers, etc. So we're going to take off the side panels, and then we're going to remove this front cowling next. So before we start the safe isolation process, we must prove our voltage indicator on a known supply, and we're going to use a proving unit. So we're going to probe in like so, so into one termination and then into the other of it. And hopefully we can see that the voltage shoots up, all our lights illuminate, and we go above the scale, off the limit. So we've proved our voltage indicator is ready to start the safe isolation procedure. Before you tell me how messy it is and use of tie wraps and what a disaster this looks like, this is a legacy panel. It's been wired by outside contractors, etc., and we're using it to prove a point for the safe isolation. I understand there's also a little plastic cap missing there. It's not essential, but it is missing. There'll be loads of things you'll be able to pick out for me. I'd appreciate it if you don't in the comments, because this is all about the isolation procedure. The caps at the bottom here are still in place, and I can't touch those live parts. I can't touch them actually with the caps down, but that they're in place. I'm going to need to move those out of the way before I start the safe isolation procedure. So just pull those down. Okay, depending on what documentation you're reading, depends on which order these 10 tests are carried out. If you look on Net Services, at their documentation about safe isolation, they talk about doing it first of all between two of the lines. So effectively starting at a potentially 400 volt test. I don't carry mine out in that way. I do it in a slightly different way. And this is something I spoke to with Sparky Ninja as well. I don't like the fact that if it was live, that once I probe onto one of the lines, the other tip's obviously going to go live and therefore potentially dangerous. So I like to do it in a slightly different order. Have a conversation with your AM2 or AM2S inspector and just confirm to him, if you do the 10 tests in the order that you're comfortable with, will it be acceptable, or would he like you to do it in a certain position, certain order? So I'm going to start off by doing what would be a 230 volt test if it was live. We're presuming it isn't because we've safely isolated it. So I'm going to test between the neutral and line conductor. I'm going to probe on in the safest possible order. So I've gone the least dangerous conductor first. So I've gone to the neutral, and then I go on to the line conductor. No volts at all. I come off the line conductor. I'm going to go to the next line. So I'm going to leave it on the neutral this time. I'm not going to take it off. So I go to the next one and L2. No volts. Come off and go to L3. No volts. Come off, and then I come off my neutral conductor. So I've done that in what's the safest possible manner, by going on the neutral first. I haven't made this tip live. If I've gone on L1 first and then on the neutral, your tip becomes live if the circuit was energized. That's the first three stages. L1, L2 and L3 tested to neutral in my sequence. Next, I'm going to test between the neutral and the protective conductor. This is a TNCS earthing arrangement, so you'll get a continuity beep. We understand that from classroom chat about how the neutral and earth are connected together. Again, I need to go in the safest order. Out the neutral and the protective conductor. The protective conductor is the safest terminal. So I'm going to probe onto that one and then onto the neutral. You'll hear a beep because that's a continuity, not a voltage reading. There's 0 volts there. And then I come off the neutral first and then off my protective conductor. That's stage 4. I'm now going to test between individual lines to the protective conductor. So we're at stage 5 now in the testing sequence. I'm going to probe onto my protective conductor first, and then I'm going to do L1, L2 and L3. Very similar process to what we did with the neutral. So onto the protective conductor, and least dangerous one first, then onto the line conductor L1, no volts, off the line L2, no volts, L3, no volts, off L3, off the protective conductor. So we're now at a stage where we've only got a test between our line conductors. We're presuming, because of the tests we've carried out so far, it's actually isolated. So at this stage, when we're probing between two conductors, which we now expect to be dead, we haven't got any issues with livening the tips up. So we're into the final stages where we go between L1 and we're going to go into L2. I'm going to come off L2 and go on to L3. And then we're going to come off L1. And gone to L2. All of those had 0 volts. Okay, so it doesn't matter which order we come off. That completes the 10 stages of testing the three-phase isolation of a, in this case, distribution board. I hope this video helps you for both AM2 and AM2S, as well as working as a contracting electrician. So before we can start confirming that absolutely the safe isolation procedure has been completed, we must prove that our instrument hasn't failed in the process. So we need to prove this before we suggest to our AM2 instructor or AM2S instructor that we are ready to start work. So probe back into our proving unit. Again, always tricky on camera. And there we go. We've proved our voltage indicator is working correctly. So at this stage, we can go back to the panel. So just to confirm, to reconfirm, we tested between L1 and neutral, stage 1, stage 2 and stage 3, with the L1, L2 and L3 to neutral. Stage 4, between protective conductor and neutral. Stage 5, 6 and 7 was L1, L2 and L3 to protective conductor. Then we did L1, L2, L1, L3, L2, L3 in order to complete the 10 stages of testing for safe isolation. You're now ready to work within this distribution board. I hope this video has been some help.